All right, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know who the Ritchie brothers are who is standing there. It's some fine company, I'm sure. I know it's not Lionel Ritchie. And as Greg said, people didn't get Ritchie today. But I'm bummed, since we don't have our own. All right, Rob Williams is here. It's Newsmax Deputy Financial Editor, and it's the Daily Closing Bell Report. And there are the numbers up on the screen. You see the Dow down 96 points at 17,641. NASDAQ down 39, and the S&P down 17. This is, what, the third day in a row the market's selling off after those two huge days last week.
Well, right. Last week we saw sell-off, then a big snap back upward, and now third day down again, unfortunately. And today, again, the story continues to be
oil. Can't take it anymore with oil.
I know. Well, oil closed below $46 a barrel today for the first time in a long time. And so, I don't know. I'm almost hoping it'll just kind of flush out, and then we can start rebuilding
rising.
Again.
Goldman Sachs lowered its outlook for oil.
Well, that's right. Goldman finally got on board with a lot of other banks that are out there with their prognosis that oil is going to decline.
So down to $40.50 in the second quarter.
Well, right, and so we're almost there. That almost seems optimistic at the way we're going now. But then again, with oil, could bounce back with demand.
And you had a Saudi prince, one of them. I'm not sure which one. I think it was the prince telling an interviewer the other day that $100 a barrel oil, never more.
Right.
That couldn't have sat too well with the oil, investors and the energy investors.
Well, yeah, it collapsed more than 50% from last summer's high.
Yeah,
and
geez.
As we talked about last week, in those kind of bubble conditions, it takes years to get back to the peak. The Nikkei in Japan's never recovered to where it was.
The NASDAQ hasn't recovered here.
The NASDAQ still has some room to go. Housing in some markets has room to go.
Right.
In New York, it's still pretty strong. It recovered pretty quickly.
All right, so let's look at some of the movers today. The earnings season kicked off.
Officially,
with Alcoa. Is that they do Alcoa because it's A? I don't know.
You'd think so.
Would have been an A with AA company with it before AL. Anyway, but go ahead. So gained up about 1% today?
1% after hours.
The report was good, no?
It was. They beat on earnings and said that they think the aluminum market's going to grow by 7% this year.
I tell you, I buy more aluminum foil every week. I like to make the little balls and throw them into the trash can. So that must be my purchase of the aluminum
foil. That must
foil.
Be either that or General Motors is putting more aluminum into their cars.
Yeah, that could be. That could be possible. Tiffany fall 14%? What's that about?
Oh, well, they said that... Their holiday sales were really disappointing, and that the stronger dollar is affecting them, especially in overseas like Asia, where they get a lot of gift buyers, and it's a very high-end name.
Yeah.
So with the stronger dollar, it makes things more expensive there.
And harder to purchase.
Harder to purchase, and so they sold off.
And Google is down 19% from its all-time high of about 11 months ago.
I know.
What's with Google? I mean, you think of Google, you think is one of these, up and coming, but constantly, coming up with new ideas. Why were they faltering the way they are?
Well, they've been in kind of a slide since last year on, also, I think a stronger dollar affecting them overseas, but also last week they didn't have a presence at the Consumer Electronics Show.
Not one product, no products at all.
Well, right. So Google Glass was kind of that. You used to hear a lot of hype about that. Those are the glasses,
right? Yeah,
that
allow
you to surf the web, but that went nowhere.
Yeah, because you kind of have to see where you're going when you're walking with glasses. Anyway, tomorrow, small business optimism. That's what we got to look for tomorrow morning.
Right. It'll be interesting to hear what small businesses think about Obamacare. That's what I'm looking
for. Oh, I know what they think about Obamacare. All right. And folks, if you want to take control of your financial future, check out moneynews.com live 24/7. We're coming back.